our hands into, the one that we turn to, the one that we look to, the one that we hope to, the one that we hope for, the one that only can save us. Amen. His name is Jesus. Let's lift up our hands and just love Him this morning before we begin our morning service, before we praise Him. Hallelujah, Lord. We worship You, Jesus. We thank You for Your grace. Thank You for Your love for us. Hallelujah. Thank You, hallelujah, for Your mercy this morning. Let's sing this song, From the Rising of the Sun. Amen. Clap with me this morning. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. Praise ye the Lord, praise Him all ye servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord from this time forth and forevermore. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. Praise ye the Lord, praise Him all ye servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. From the rising name of the Lord, from this time forth and forevermore. Praise ye the Lord, hallelujah. Praise ye the Lord, praise Him all ye servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord from this time forth and forevermore. He's my everything. He is my everything. He is my all. He is my everything, both great and small. He gave His life for me, makes everything new. He is my everything. Now how about you? Like honey in the rock, hallelujah. Like honey in the rock, sweet honey in the rock. For He tastes like honey in the rock. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. For He tastes like honey in the rock. He's my everything, hallelujah. He is my everything. He is my all. He is my everything, both great and small. He gave His life for me, makes everything new. He is my everything. Now how about you? Like honey in the rock, sweet honey in the rock, sweet honey in the rock. For He tastes like honey in the rock. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. For He tastes just like honey in the rock. Like honey in the rock this morning, like honey in the rock. Sweet honey in the rock. For he tastes like honey in the rock. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. For he tastes like honey in the rock. How many ways this morning? How many ways can I get back to God? To God the Father above. How many doors can I enter through? To God the Father of love. How many likes this morning? How many likes can I see on the way? To God the Father above. The answer, my friend, hallelujah. The answer, my friend, is written in God's word. The answer is written in God's word. Jesus alone this morning, hallelujah. Jesus alone is the way back to God. To God the Father above. Jesus alone is the door that will lead to God the Father of love. Jesus alone, Jesus alone is the light that will shine to God the Father above. The answer, my friend, hallelujah. The answer, my friend, is written in God's word. The answer is written in God's word. The answer, my friend, hallelujah. The answer, my friend, is written in God's word. The answer is written in God's word. One more time, the answer, my friend, hallelujah. The answer, my friend, is written in God's word. The answer is written in God's word. Let's give him a big clap offering this morning. Yes, Lord, we worship you. Hallelujah. We're going to slow it down this morning. We're going to sing this song, How Great Is Our God. We'd like you to join with me to lift up your hands and begin to sing unto him this morning. The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let the earth rejoice. The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice. Let all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself, he wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and tremble at his voice, and tremble at his voice. How great this morning, how great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God. H-U-H he stands, hallelujah. In age to age he stands, and time is in his hands. Beginning and the end, beginning and the end. The Godhead, hallelujah, the Godhead
three in one. Father, Spirit, Son. Father, Spirit, Son. The Lion and the Lamb. The Lion and the Lamb. How great is our God. How great is our God. Sing with me. How great is our God. And all will see how great. Name above all name, name above all name, you are worthy of all praise. My heart will sing, how great is our God. Name above all name. Name, you are worthy of all praise. My heart will sing, how great is our God. The splendor of our King, the splendor of the King. Lord in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, let all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and tremble at his voice. And tremble at his words. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God. How great is our God this morning. How great is our God. Sing in me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God. Name above all names this morning. How great is our God. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God. Sunday we worship you. Amen, Father, as we stand before you, we thank you this morning for your goodness, for your kindness through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And this morning, this privilege that we have to be able to stand before you in the house of God. It's all because of you, Father in heaven. It's all because of you through your Son, Jesus Christ. And through the help of the Holy Spirit, we are able to be here this morning. And we are so grateful this morning for this time and day that we have. This morning we bring before you in prayer, O God, Pastor Greg Mitchell, Pastor Joe Campbell, Pastor Alan Nasir, and all the area works before you, the work in Sabah, Pastor Trevor Fong, the work here, the work in USJ, Pastor Gregory, the work in PJ, Pastor Allen and Puchong, in Jesus' name, Pastor Joel, and all the works before you, every missionary, every evangelist before you, Lord Almighty, praying God all over us, so Lord, praying God for your divine protection and covering in Jesus' name. Use us, God, for your glory and for your purpose this morning. We bring all the helpers and disciples and workers before you as well. O God Almighty, this morning, hallelujah, our families in prayer before you, our loved ones who are not saved, Father, we call them out unto you, Lord. Have mercy upon our loved ones who are not saved. Speak to them. Open the eyes of their heart, Lord. This morning, in Jesus' name, bringing one another before you, in Jesus' name. Father, we pray for breakthroughs among your people. And Lord God Almighty, I commit Mukesh before you. A thought of his name come into my mind, God. And I commit him unto you, Lord. I ask your blessing upon his life, O Lord God Almighty, in the new work he's doing, God. In the name of Jesus, God, bless him, God. Open doors for him in Jesus' name. And even in this church here, among your people, those who are going through, O Lord God, obstacles, those who are going through, needing a breakthrough in their life, Lord, we pray, God, hallelujah, that you grant them a breakthrough in Jesus' name. The Bible conference in the month of May 31st, hallelujah, we pray, God, that you bless the Bible conference in the name of Jesus Christ. Even this morning, God, we uphold, Lord God, this morning service before you, remembering Sister Anu and her children, they are not well, and we pray, God, God Almighty, strengthen their immune system in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, my wife and Jasper and Joanne flying back today. We pray for Journey Mercy and Jordan as well in Japan. And oh God, also those who are traveling, we pray, God, for your hands upon them. Those who are not here, wherever they are, Lord, this morning, God, that you still minister unto them, Lord God Almighty. Lord God, speak to their hearts. Oh God, help them, oh God. In the name of Jesus, commit the new place before you, the renovation that's going on, God. We pray that, God, all will be well, all will flow accordingly. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, bless every one of us. Lord God Almighty, we want to remember, Lord, your promise, so Lord, make to us that, God, you will bless us here in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you again for your presence here, again this privilege to be able to be before you in Jesus' mighty name. We thank you and pray. Amen. Let's give a big clap to the Lord. Amen. Could you just turn around and greet one another or welcome one another here in the house of God as I give to you the quick announcement this morning. Amen. So we welcome you a very blessed Resurrection Sunday morning this morning. And I want to give you the announcement. Tonight service is at 6 o'clock prayer and a 7 o'clock service in the evening. And then Wednesday we will have our midweek worship service. So noted that on the 24th we are planning to move most of the things from here to the new place. So 24th is Hari Raya. I'm not sure first day or second day. I know it's a holiday, and we are planning to be here at 9 o'clock in the morning. I encourage you to come. Lend me your hand, lend us your hands, and let's be about going, moving from here. This is the first time we move, okay? So we've been here for like 20 plus years in this place, and 20 plus years of things here, and this is the first time we move, and praise God we are able to move to our own place of worship. Amen. Which means that we don't need to worry about shifting. We don't need to worry about the landlord changing his mind about, you know, not wanting to rent us, or we don't have to worry about the landlord wanting to increase the rent, you know, something like that, you know. So we are so grateful to God for opening this door for us to be there. So 24th, I will again Monday double check with the management PV128 whether we could do it on that day, because I heard that it's a holiday, you might not be able, they will not be able to allow us to do any moving. I'll let you know on Monday or Tuesday whether it's confirmed, but tentatively 24th of this month, Monday morning, we want to move most of the things here to the new place. Okay, so praise God. Amen. I just want to read to you to what you call that quotes this morning. Okay, my handphone. So one is from J.L. Kraft. Some of you love cheese, and you know the brand Kraft, very famous brand, cheese and butter and frozen products. So this man is a Christian, and he says, the only investment I ever make which has paid consistently increasing dividends is the money I have given to the Lord. I like that statement that he made about consistent dividends. Okay, the word consistent means it's always, you know, it's always there. It always comes. The dividends that this man received, it always continuously, you know, when I begin to give back to the Lord, when I begin to give to the Lord, it always consistently, it never misses. Okay, God's giving, it always comes back to you. And another quote, if I may read to you, is from David Livingston. Okay, David Livingston, he's a missionary to South Africa. Okay, and at that time he went to Africa, which was full of tribes, and he went into the jungle, and this man began to share the word of God in the jungle to these tribes of people. And he has this to say: I place no value on anything I have or may possess except in relation to the kingdom of God. If anything will advance the interests of the kingdom, it shall be given away. Only as by giving, I shall most promote the glory of Him, to whom my own, all my hopes in time or eternity. So this man says that I own all my hopes to God, to Jesus. And this man says that, you know what, to promote the glory of God, if anything will advance the interests of the kingdom of God, I will give it. Okay? If anything will advance, it shall be given away. So this morning, we want to come before God with our giving. And let's give to the work of God this morning. Amen. Let's give to the kingdom of God our offerings, our tithes. Hallelujah, this morning. And you could you pray.
Amen. So I need two strong men to come and help. Okay. James, are you strong? Okay, can you come and help move this pulpit? Sam, you're still very strong, Sam. Okay, can I say? Just move this thing back. Can I move the down one? Just the side. Okay, can. All right. Okay. Can. Okay. All right, thank you. That's great. This is enough, Fabiola? You need further back? Okay, good. So we want to welcome our church children. So they have a presentation on this Resurrection Sunday morning service. Amen. So four of them, right? You're coming up. So let's give four of them a big warm welcome as they come and present on this day for the glory of the Lord. Thank you very much, children. Let's give them another big warm applause. Amen. Amen. It takes a lot of courage to come up here, you know. So we thank God for them. Amen. This morning. Amen. Okay. This is a very heavy pulpit. Amen. Thank you very much, man. So praise God for that presentation. And again, we welcome you for this Sunday morning, Resurrection Sunday morning service. And we're going to turn to the book of Matthew 28. Matthew 28, verse 1 to 8. Upstairs is a bit messy, okay? So We have removed all the air cons upstairs, so it's a bit messy. So if you're going up, just need to be careful, okay? So by this Sunday, probably, I will be using that portable speaker to preach. We might be dismantling the wiring and the speakers. We might be, okay, to prepare to move over there. So just to update you a little bit, okay? So the stage may look a bit out of order, all right? So if you do see the stage look a bit out of order, okay, don't be surprised. So anyway, Matthew 28, verse 1 to 8, if you could stand to your feet. We want to read together. I read verse 1, you read verse 2. Now, after the Sabbath, as the first day of the week began to dawn, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. Verse 2. His countenance was like lightning. His clothing as white as snow. Was four. But the angel answered and said to the woman, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead, and indeed he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." Verse 8. Father, we thank you for this very morning and resurrection morning. And we thank you for all that you are doing for us and have done for us. We ask you this morning to speak to us from your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today is the morning. Christian churches around the world celebrate what we have come to know as Easter. It is the day. Just a few days ago, my eldest brother says that in England, Friday to Sunday is a big thing there. Good Friday, right down to Sunday, is a holiday there. It's a long weekend, and it's a big thing there. Though my brother, he is not a Christian, but he sent an image of the cross and three crosses and Jesus in the middle. And but anyway, he says that it's a big thing there. So most of the world celebrate what we know as Easter. It is the day where churches all over the world celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead. Now, as I said, today is commonly known as Easter. But instead of calling it Easter, I want you to better call it Resurrection Sunday, okay? So from now on, I want you to change. I know this is not easy because we have all come to call it Easter Day. Okay? But it's better to call it Resurrection Sunday. This may take getting used to it because Easter is the usual word. We used to call this day, but nevertheless, it is not impossible. Now, the reason why I would that you do so is because the word Easter is believed to come from the word estre, E-A-S-T-R-E, which is a name for goddess of spring and fertility. So this word Easter, the word, original word is the word E-A-S-T-R-E, and Istri is a goddess. It is a goddess of spring and fertility. Many of the tradition used in worshipping this goddess is still practiced until this day. For example, the Easter Bunny. Easter Bunny is a symbol of fertility, fruitfulness. The Easter egg, painted with bright colors, symbolize spring. Okay, so symbolize the sunlight of spring. And the giving of basket filled with, you know, things inside are just some of the few traditions that is still, until today, you see in the world, is commonly practiced. When people think of Easter, they think of that rabbit, okay? And the rabbit eggs and the eggs and all that kind of things, you know. So their mind goes straight to that, and you can just imagine that, you know, these things is still around. But anyway, it comes from the word Istri, and that word is a goddess of fertility and spring. So for that reason, every year when it comes to Good Friday, do remember to call this day as Resurrection Sunday. If you wish somebody a blessed Resurrection Sunday morning, because it's all about Jesus Christ rising from the dead on this morning. So on this Resurrection Sunday morning, I would like to look with you what was said to us from that day on the first Sunday of Resurrection. We have this first Resurrection Sunday here in Matthew 28. Now, as we consider our text here, we can see that in those 8 verses, there are many things happening on the first Resurrection Sunday morning, when Mary Magdalene was there to see the tomb. First, they were both welcomed in a way by a great earthquake when they went to the site where Jesus was buried. And the cause behind that great earthquake was not because of nature, or there's a split in the earth down there that shift and cause that place to begin to quake, but rather because an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, okay, and when he came down, he rolled back the stone, and I believe that stone that was rolled back must be a huge, big stone, because it is sealed not to be removed by any thieves that wants to steal, because it's a rich man's tomb. Jesus was buried in a rich man's tomb, borrowed tomb, but it belongs to a rich man, and it was sealed in order that no thieves and robbers can go inside or remove the stone. But this angel was able to roll back the stone, and then what he did was, on that morning, he sat on the stone, which is doing, causes a great earthquake-like effect to take place. The next was his appearance, the angel's appearance. The Bible says his face was like lightning, okay? And his clothes as white as snow. The other thing that happened were the guards that were there. And the guards that were there, they stood, who stood to guard the tomb, they were like zombies. They were all in fear, became like dead men because of what they have just experienced and saw on that morning. And the next shocking thing, together with all that is happening, is when the angel invited both Mary and Mary Magdalene to see for themselves the tomb, which the tomb was empty. And the angel told them these words: "He's not here, for he is risen. As he say, come, see the place where the Lord lay." And other versions is that when they went in to see, it was an empty tomb. There was no body there. The body of Jesus is not there, just a napkin face folded nicely, placed there, but it was an empty tomb. The day our Lord rose from the dead is full of happening. A day filled with all manner of sounds and emotions and sights. And likewise, this morning, when the second coming of Jesus comes, it will be an earthquake moment in a way. Sounds and effects and the angel blowing the trumpet and the voice coming from the voice of the angel and everything that takes place is going to be, in a way, an earthquake effect moment. Now, for this message for this day, I want to look at two things with you. The two things that I want to consider with you has to do with this earth-shaking, shining, whiter-than-snow angel, and what this angel has to say to both of them and to you and I this morning on Resurrection Sunday morning. And that is first in verse 6, okay, whereby the angel say he is not here, for he is risen. And then he make these three words or statement, as he said. Okay. So this angel begin to say to Mary and Mary Magdalene, he's not here, for he is risen. And then he went on to say, as he said. Okay, as Jesus said. So I want to look at these three words, as he said, spoken by the angel. What both Mary and Mary Magdalene saw in that tomb, which was emptiness, was spoken before, or way before it had actually happened. And it was spoken by Jesus himself that what will happen in the future about him will happen exactly when the day comes. When the day he died, on the third day, what he say, he is risen, he will rise again from the dead. The angel begin to remind and say to Mary, Mary Magdalene, as he say, as Jesus say, that he will rise again, he will rise again. And Mark 9:31, for he taught his disciples and said to them, the Son of Man is being betrayed. As he taught his disciples and said to them, the Son of Man is being betrayed into the hands of men, and they will kill him. And after he is killed, Jesus says he will rise the third day. Mark 9:31, when he was teaching his disciples, the Son of Man is being betrayed into the hands of men, they will kill him, and after he is killed, he will rise the third day. Again in Luke 18, then he took the 12 aside and said to them, behold, we are going up to Jerusalem, and all things that are written by the prophets concerning the Son of Man will be accomplished. For he will be delivered to the Gentiles, will be mocked and insulted and spit upon. 33, Luke 18, they will scourge him, they will whip him and kill him. And the third day, Jesus says, the Son of Man, the Son of God, will rise again. Jesus, in these two books, Mark and Luke, was very detailed. And what will happen to him? He'll be scourged, he'll be mocked, he'll be spit upon. He'll be delivered to the Gentiles. Okay, he will be betrayed. He will die. He will be killed. And then he make this statement. And after he is killed, he will rise the third day. Luke 18. And the third day he says, he will rise again. And happen it did. Just as the angels say to both of Mary, as he said, he will rise again.
Now this tells us this morning that whatever Jesus has to say to us from his word, from the Bible, about what will happen, will happen. This tells us the words of Jesus, the words of the Bible. When God says something to you and I, that something that God will say to you and I will happen exactly as he say this morning. If he has made you a promise, okay, of never leaving you, if he had made you a promise, he will open door. If he made you a promise that he made will come to pass. Or if he have warned you from the Bible, okay, if he have warned you from the Bible about certain things, about certain warning, for example, if you look at a woman and if you lust after her in your heart, you have committed adultery in your heart, surely, that words that he say, okay, will surely happen. If he has spoken in the form of encouragement or action, that is whatever you take, this will happen. It will happen. If he says, when you receive him, you become a child of God. You become a child of God. If he spoke about he has given you power and authority as a child of God, you have power and authority with you and in you. If he says that if one demon is cast out from someone, and if that person does not fill his heart with God's word, fill his heart with the Spirit of God, then that demon, if he say, will go out, and then he will come back and he will look at that person, and if he sees that person empty, there's nothing there, he doesn't feel it with the Spirit of God, he doesn't feel it with the Word of God, this demon will go out and bring 8 more and go inside that person, and the end of the day, that person will be worse than before. That what he says will happen. As he says means at the end of the day, the words spoken by Jesus Christ will come to pass. If he says give, and he will be given back to you. It will be given back to you, just as he say that when you do it, it will be done to you. If he says to you, if you would lift up yourself, he will humble you. If you lift up yourself, if you pride yourself, he will humble you. He will humble you. But if you humble yourself, he will exalt you. When you humble yourself, that exaltation, he will promote you. Just as they saw what Jesus had said to them before their eyes, you and I will see also what Jesus says to us before our eyes. It will happen just as he says. This can be both an encouragement. This should be an encouragement to you and I to know this morning that whatever Jesus says, it will happen. And this can be both an encouragement and both as a warning. Okay, because it will happen just as the angel says, as he say, he will rise again, he will rise again. As he say, they saw it with their own eyes, Mary and Mary Magdalene, that Jesus Christ certainly had risen from the dead. The second thing I want to look at with you is what the angel told them to do in verse number 7. Go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. So in verse 7, next the angel says to both Mary, go. Go, okay. Go quickly and tell. Go is a common command, common word used by Jesus Christ, and now used by his messenger, the angel, to both the Mary Magdalene. Go quickly and tell the woman caught in adultery,
Jesus says to the woman, go and sin no more. To the blind man unable to see, go and wash in the pool of Siloam. Okay. In Matthew 5:41, if anyone forces you to go 1 mile, go with them 2 miles. Go the extra mile. But the most important goal among the many goals is the goal here told by the angel, which what Jesus himself has said, and that is go and tell. Mark 16, verse 15. This is the great commission given. Go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. This goal here is the same as told by the angel to both Mary and Magdalene. That is, go and tell. And this morning, on Resurrection Sunday morning, if God has a word for you, a command to you, that word to you this morning, maybe as you're seated here, you're asking God, God, speak to me. God, give me a word, God. God, give me a message. God will say to you this morning, go and tell. Okay? Go and tell. This would be the same command that he will give to every one of us who is born again, who is a Christian this morning. Go and tell. Because here is the good news. Here is good news for both Mary and Mary Magdalene. The gospel. Go and tell this morning. This is the good news or the gospel that we are to go and tell. We all have a responsibility to not keep quiet, okay, but to go and tell about the good news. Okay. Why? Because it is good news. Good news in the sense is because it gives hope for those who feel that they have no hope. Good news in the sense because there's still a way. Good news because there's still a solution to their problems that they're going through. They don't have to take drastic situation. They don't have to commit suicide. They don't have to do other things. Good news is that God can answer their problem. God can begin to save them from the trials and the troubles that they are going. Good news to every father. Go and tell every father, every mother. Okay, go and tell every brother and every sister. Go and tell the dissatisfied people, like the woman in the well, you know, who is dissatisfied, married 5 times, and the sixth is not her husband. Go and tell them that the answer is Jesus Christ. There's an answer to their problem. And this morning, you and I have this great commission in a way, on Resurrection Sunday morning, to be reminded that you and I have a good news. You can't keep it. You must not. You have tasted yourself how good the good news is. It has changed your life. It has refreshed your soul. It has turned you into someone that is of a sound mind. It has brought a healing to your marriage, healing to your own mind and heart, healing to your family, healing to your work and your marriages. Go, don't keep it this morning. And again, if you want a message on Sunday, Resurrection, this is it. Go and tell, because all of us this morning have a responsibility to do that. Because the only solution, the only hope that can give an answer to this world, to a marriage that's breaking down, okay, to a son who maybe is possessed like the son of this man in the Bible, who's possessed by demons, or to a dissatisfied woman, like the woman at the well, married 5 times. The sixth is not her husband. The only thing that can bring real joy and full satisfaction is the gospel. It's the good news. Jesus died. Jesus rose again from the dead. Amen. Jesus rose from the dead. Death could not hold him. The most deadliest problem on earth is death. Okay. When death comes, there's no more answer in the way. But there's still an answer through Christ. Jesus died, but he rose again from the death dead, which means this morning there's hope for anyone who's in a impossible situation for them, that this morning, that when they put their faith and hope in Christ, Christ can begin to help them this morning with what they are going through. So on this Resurrection Sunday morning, the words of this angel to both Mary and Mary Magdalene is, he reminded them firstly of what Jesus said. What Jesus said, what the Bible say, when he said it, you can guarantee that when you put it into action, it will come to pass. When you believe in it, it will come to pass. And also this morning, you and I have a responsibility of telling our neighbors, telling our colleagues, telling our children, telling our family members about the good news this morning. Amen. Would you like you to stand to your feet? We're going to serve communion. Brother Sabri and Daniel, could you come and help? You hold the bread and the cup in your hand, just want you to remember, go back to time 2,000 years ago. On the cross, our Lord so loved us, he gave himself for you and I, looking unto Jesus, the author and developer of our faith. If it didn't happen that day, if it didn't take place that day, there'll be no salvation for anyone. But because Jesus Christ humbled himself, obey the Father, gave himself for us. As you know, on the cross, it was no easy death. He died a slow death. If I were to die, I prefer a quick death, just an instant one. But he died a slow death. Hours he was hanging on the cross. And just imagine, his feet was bended. His knees was bended. That nail on his feet, and they didn't do it straight, purposely bend it. Every time he takes a deep breath, and how many deep breaths he would have taken, the pain. This tells us this morning how serious sin is. This tells us what hell is like to those who go there without Jesus. This tells us how much the price that was paid to save us, plus the other two other nails on the left, one on the right, and another nail on top. Jesus Christ paid the price. Father, we thank you for your great love for us. You sent your only begotten Son to pay the price for our sins. It was our sins. It's not the sin of Jesus. He never sinned. He knew no sin. He took our sin. All the sin of adultery, homosexual, the sin of jealousy, all the sin, murder, every sin was placed on him. He paid for us. And Father, we thank you this morning. And Jesus, we thank you for your obedience. As Father, we remember this morning Christ's sacrifice for us. As we break the bread and eat of the bread this morning and drink of the cup, Father, we go before you with a heart of appreciation and thankfulness, thanking you always for all that you have done for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's break the bread in two. And let's eat of the bread. Let's drink of the cup. Amen. And God bless all of you. And again, a blessed Resurrection Sunday morning. Amen. Go in the joy of the Lord. Have fellowship with one another this morning. Amen.